I need $1 million in cash. I need Don Corleone, those politicians that you carry in your pocket, like so many nickels and dimes.
Around 6 months ago, a wise guy named Bruno came to the realization that the world owed him big and that he'd make a better godfather than anybody. El Serpe, head of a respected family in the district, caught wind of Bruno's plans to hold up his very own casino. He got furious to hear about this, because he once welcomed Bruno into his own home and even schooled him on how to survive in their ruthless world. But Bruno still wanted to bite the hand that once fed him. This betrayal was dealt swiftly and clean. An ambush was set up using armed young, beautiful girls with a rabbit hat to lure Bruno to his fall. The ambush worked almost perfectly. The Puccinello family was astoundingly crippled, but Godfather Bruno managed to survive the ambush and escape to safety. His pride would not let him hide and give up on seeking out the ones responsible for the death of his entire crew. So he used his connections and gathered a death squad, and he devised a plan to take out the whole Demarcos. Some cops to chase them out the back door of a restaurant, down a dark alleyway and into a trap. The trap failed miserably for Bruno. The DeMarco's superior weapon skills was far too much for the angry death squad. This time Godfather Bruno found no escape, except in his own violent and bloody demise. New opportunities opened up for Aegis. The first thing they did was take over Bruno's strip club and throw a massive party with free drinks. Kids, time to go to bed. Don't have too much gory dreams.